Today. Today, we're going to make a strong effort to help ourselves according to the Word of God.
Amen.
So before we go any further, let us move to refocus our minds on what God has for us today.
Amen.
Father God, I come bringing myself, surrendering to your will today, that your will might be done. Take me, oh God, shape me, make me, mold me, do with me as you will. Let your word come forth with power and authority.
Amen.
Cast down any and every part of me that may desire to rise up, that it may be recognized. May it be called what it is. It is just that. Let the Spirit of God reign. Let God have his way in here today.
Amen.
For though I live for Christ.
Amen.
And my voice and my mouth, I surrender it to God now. That his will be done.
Amen.
Speak now, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That we may know the truth. Amen.
Lord. Amen.
Amen. Let us open our Bibles to the book of St. John. And we're going to go to chapter 1 and verse 46. Chapter 1 and verse 46. And it reads, "And Nathanael said unto him," who is him? Him is Philip. Philip has had an interruption and an introduction into his life of Jesus the Christ. And Philip has gone and found Nathanael. He says, "We have found him of whom Moses in the law and the prophets did write, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." And Nathanael said unto him, "Can there any good thing come out of Nazareth?" I repeat, Philip is talking to Nathanael. Hear what he has said to Nathanael, and then what Nathanael says back to him. Philip says to Nathanael, "We have found him of whom Moses in the law and the prophets did write, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." Now, Nathanael responds. And Nathanael said unto him, "Can there any good thing come out of Nazareth?" No doubt, as we read these words as they are written, and we hear my efforts to place the emphasis on the words that would help carry their meaning, we can see that there is an instantaneous rejection or subjection of the possibility that this could be Jesus that has been spoken of because of where he comes from. Because of where he comes from. What's being challenged here is not the equating of Philip with the name Jesus and who has said what he is, but the equating of him coming from Nazareth. Mm-hmm. Nathaniel says, Philip, come on, Philip. Mm-hmm. Philip, 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 Philip. Come on, Philip. Can any good thing come out of Nazareth? Mm. In this statement, there is no indication that he wasn't willing to receive the knowledge that there was Jesus. Mm-hmm. But what he wasn't willing to receive was that he came out of Nazareth. Mm-hmm. Why? What's so significant about Nazareth? Well, you've got a Nazareth. That's what's so significant about it. Because people know about you. And they know about your family. They know where you have lived. And they know the history of people in your family. They may know this information personally, or it has been revealed to them over course of time. Perhaps it has even been written in a book. So therefore, just the mention of your name immediately evokes a particular type of response. Mm-hmm. This is your Nazareth. You are much like a book. So we're going to talk about this. We're going to talk about the book shelf, and the book case.
Okay.
We're going to talk about the book shelf, and the book case. Mm-hmm. Nathaniel had heard exactly what Philip had said. And as he listened to what Philip said, he was creating a mental picture of Philip, of Jesus, rather. And this mental picture of Jesus was not a pretty one. Much like this book here. It's not exactly a pretty book. Mm-hmm. If you're just looking at it from the outside. But that's all Nathaniel had. He didn't know anything about the content. He just had the book. Mm-hmm. Philip brought him the book. And he looked at the book that was spoken to him. Uh-huh. And he said, can there be any good thing that can come out of Nazareth? Now, we have this understanding in our society today. We are familiar with hearing, don't judge a book by its cover. And we understand that that means that you cannot know what's inside the book without reading the book. That's what it means. It means if you want to know what's inside the book, read the book. Uh-huh. Don't look at the cover of the book.
Right.
And then speak as if you know what's on the inside. Hmm. But we're going to go a little further here today. We're going to talk about the book in entirety, as well as the book on the bookshelf, and the book in the bookcase. And as we explore and gain some understanding about this, I want you to place yourself in the position of the book. You're the book. You are the book.
Okay.
Don't speak. Don't do anything. You're going to be presented to the world. How are you presented? They see and observe you. They take in information that helps them recognize you. You, the book, on the bookshelf. Mm-hmm. They see you. And they say, there is a person who is black. And then they see you and they say, there is a person who is Chinese. They see someone else and they say, they are Cherokee Indian. They see you, the book, and they immediately classify you by what they observe. Mm-hmm. Because they have done this process, they immediately also began to place you on a shelf. Uh-huh. This shelf is your family. This shelf is your books of association. Mm-hmm. You are only you. You are this book. You are not all those other books that are on the shelf that they just put you on and mixed you in with. Mm. But they now will begin to make a further evaluation of you because they have put you on this bookshelf. They're going to say that you come from Nazareth. Remember now, you're the book. Jesus is the book. Jesus comes from Nazareth. Nazareth is his bookshelf. On his bookshelf are other books. Mm-hmm. They are not him. On your bookshelf are other books, but they are not you. Mm-hmm. But people have now associated you with the books that are on the bookshelf that they have put you on. Mm-hmm. It's important that you understand you are not putting yourself on this bookshelf. This bookshelf has been given to you. You have been placed there. Mm-hmm. So now you come out of that bookshelf.